Dr. Rumanu, what has been South Sudan's experience with implementation of preventative OCV campaigns?
Yeah, South Sudan had an eventful period with disease outbreak since the country obtained its independence in 2011. Cholera happened to be one such events. Oral cholera vaccine campaigns have been conducted in South Sudan since 2012 after we got our independence. Today, South Sudan deployed over 3.8 million doses of OCV in 45 campaigns targeting population in 23 out of 80 counties in the country. The first OCV campaign conducted in the country was in four refugee camps in Maban County between December 2012 and February 2013, targeting approximately 160,000 people. And upon creation of the OCV global stockpile in 2013, there have been a total of 45 OCV vaccination campaigns in South Sudan, the majority of which were two-dose campaigns, and half of the campaigns were carried out in IDP or refugee camps, where high concentration of people and lack of basic services, such as water and sanitation, make the risk of cholera infection particularly high. Indeed, until 2016, all of the requests from South Sudan to access the OCV global stockpile were addressed to the International Coordinating Group, ICG, for an emergency use of the vaccine. Nevertheless, during 2017, there was an extensive use of OCV, mostly because of the major cholera outbreak that ravaged vast areas of the country. In such context, OCV is believed to have been fundamental as a reactive tool to curb the outbreak. Therefore, it is only in 2017 that the country prepared a more comprehensive plan to control cholera, which included the preemptive use of OCV. Here, the request for 2.1 million doses was addressed to the Global Task Force on Cholera Control. These doses were deployed as a preventive tool, targeting cholera hotspot areas throughout the country. The deployment of cholera vaccines alongside other interventions likely contributed to no new confirmed cholera cases in South Sudan in 2018, 2019, and up to 2020. However, most of the campaigns implemented in the cholera hotspots in 2017 and 2018 have now reached the 3 years they are expected to confer protection. Thus, this hotspot population previously protected from the risk of cholera outbreaks are now vulnerable to the risk of outbreaks since the underlying risk factors have not been addressed. As such, OCV remains an appropriate intervention in South Sudan's context. Thank you.